The 1970s, a decade of cinematic revolution. An army of young filmmakers stormed the decaying studios to liberate the cinema from the extravagant and over-budget period epics and speak out to a generation of young audience who never usually got a mention at the cinema. Names like Francis Ford Coppolla, Martin Scorsese, George Lucas fought to produce films throughout the decade that would speak to unsung members of the American people, a nation of anti-war, anti-establishment demonstrators and free love enthusiasts, the remnants of a swinging sixties. They wanted gritty movies that reflected their anger and grief with the Vietnam War, the distrust of the government after Nixon and Watergate. However, unknown to the studios themselves, there was a lone soldier within their city walls, their own 20-something scruff, a filmmaker with a little more love and respect for the old system. Steven Spielberg had waltzed right in, and through his work on various television programs, he managed to secure himself a deal to direct a number of TV movies for Universal. Whether he knew it or not, he was going to revolutionise the studios from the inside. His first feature was Duel, based on a short story by writer Richard Matheson, who also wrote the screenplay. It was a story with one main character, hardly any dialogue, and miles of dusty road. And not forgetting a menacing rust-coloured truck. Its protagonist was David Mann, Dennis Weaver, a salesman driving across the Californian desert in his Plymouth Valiant. It's not long before he meets a truck that slows his journey. For a while they harmlessly overtake each other, but when the unknown truck driver waves Mann past him and into an oncoming vehicle, the game suddenly becomes a tense and dangerous fight for survival. Spielberg, being unusually young to have been offered this opportunity, picked it up and ran with it. The first great decision he made was to film every last shot of this adventure out there, on location, on the highway. Surprisingly, the studio executives warned him that it would be both costly and time-consuming to film on the road and recommended that the director should use rear projections for certain inserts. Spielberg opted for the road and plotted out his entire movie on storyboards alongside a giant wall-sized map of the journey. As David Mann, Weaver is well cast. He's a gawky, bespectacled man, weak-looking and weak in spirit too from what his phone conversation with his wife tells us. He has no heroic qualities. He could just as likely be you or I. Subsequently, we feel his fear. It becomes his journey to find the strength to face up to this monster, a journey that similar characters will have to take in future Spielberg films. Spielberg's clever use of filming against moving backgrounds such as a rock face or embankment allowed him to simulate breakneck speeds whilst actually barely moving. Not showing the driver's face enabled the truck itself to become a mindless monster as opposed to a manned vehicle, therefore creating a heightened sense of doom. The shots of the truck plunging in slow motion down a cliff face and shrouding in a cloud of red dust is almost the very same shot that he chose for the demise of the great white shark that would terrorise Amity Island in 4 years' time. To accompany both farewell shots, the director also included the roar of the T-Rex from the 1925 movie The Lost World. As above the debris, both Mann and Brody manically celebrate the relief of their survival and evidence of how close they came to their fear-induced insanity, or how close they were to devolving back to primitive savages. Duel was such a success that the studio allowed Spielberg to add additional footage to bring the picture up to a runtime that would allow it to be released theatrically, and it received a great response, particularly in Europe. As a product of the 70s, the movie displayed effective on-location footage, fine editing and a steady pace, with Hitchcock suspense. As the debut feature for one of cinema's most accomplished directors, Duel remains as near-perfect and timeless as it did on its release, and a great taster of the delights yet to be produced from this infant in an industry full of old men. Strangely enough, Spielberg would make movies which would play a great part in ending his friend's assault on the studios. Films like Jaws, Close Encounters, E.T. would once again place the power of filmmaking back into the hands of the studios where they would maximise budget and profit. Only a handful of his friends would make it through the battle. Once again in Hollywood, it was money and scale that would make it to the screen. Well, thanks for listening. Feel free to comment below and don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you like what you see. There's always more films to discuss. Good night.